There is only one gospel that saves. This is the gospel of Christ in your New Testament Bible. Do not follow the gospels created by man. Jesus is very specific on this. Either you're with him or you're against him. His way is the only way. Matthew 12:30. He that is not with me is against me, and he that gathereth not with me scattereth abroad. Either you are following his way and keeping his commandments, or you have fallen astray to a false one created by a false prophet. There is only one way that saves, one gospel. It's the one Jesus and his apostles gave us, and it's written down for you in your New Testament Bible. Do not rely on others. You need to study. Your life depends on it. You must be taught by God and his book and live it. If you do not have the gospel of Christ, you do not have God. Jesus commissioned his followers to disciple the nations, preach repentance and remission of sins in his name, for them to be baptized both in water and spirit. Repent and believe his gospel. Believe means obey. Keep his commandments. Deny yourself daily and follow him. It is not the Protestant gospel of faith alone, once saved, always saved, easy believism, void of obedience and repentance, easy divorce and remarriage. For adulterers and heretics don't enter the kingdom. Persisting in sin will lead to perishing. Don't listen to the reformers. It is also not the Catholic gospel. Mary is not the Queen of Heaven, is not to be worshipped or venerated. Idolaters will not enter the kingdom. You do not say prayers to Mary. Don't listen to the theology of the popes. It is not Old Testament adherence either, or parts of it, or Saturday Sabbath keeping. Jesus directly gave his disciples his eschatology. He warned not to be led by false prophets and false Christs. There will be an abomination of desolation spoken of by Daniel the prophet. There will be affliction such as was not from the beginning of creation, which God created unto this time, neither shall be. After which there will be astrological signs, and they shall see the Son of Man coming in the clouds with great power and glory, and then he will gather his elect. It's post-tribulation premillennialism. Please study Matthew 24:29-31, Mark 13:24, Revelation 19:20. It's not pre-tribulation. It's not amillennialism or post-millennialism either. Wrong eschatology was concocted by man. Number two, worldliness. Jesus and his disciples taught to come out of the world and be salt and light. The love of the world is enmity with God. It's not health and wealth and prosperity. The apostles were satisfied with food and clothing, doing the work of the kingdom, encouraging others to store treasures in heaven instead. For Jesus warned the cares of this life and the deceit of riches would render a person fruitless. If you do not abide in Christ, you will wither, die, get cut off, and burn. If you do not abide in Christ, you cannot bear any fruit. John 15. Number three, obedience to him and his words. This is what believing the gospel means. It's not easy believism, once saved, always saved Calvinism. His gospel teaches mercy, grace, and eternal salvation for those who obey him, wrath and judgment for those who don't obey him. His gospel teaches judgment on those persisting in sin. And it came to pass as he spake these things, a certain woman of company lift up her voice and said unto him, Blessed is the womb that bare thee and the paps that thou suck. But he said, Yea, rather blessed are they that hear the word and keep it. Divorce and remarriage is adultery. This is a strict teaching few abide with. Jesus taught man and woman, when married, become one flesh. This was defined by God. There is no cause for putting away. Only death of a spouse ends a marriage. If spouses don't reconcile and they separate, they are to remain single. Divorce and remarriage to someone else becomes adultery. Adulterers do not enter the kingdom. Number 5. False religion kills souls because people prefer doctrines of man over God. You see, the religious order rejected Messiah, seeking ways to kill him. They were the false teachers of the day, preaching precepts of man which invalidated the words of God. A generation of vipers on the path to hell. Blind guides leading the blind to the pit, looking for excuses for adultery. Apart from Jesus, they would die in their sins. Common false gospels of man today repeat. A. The gospel of worldliness, prosperity, health, and wealth. Their believers think Christian means blessing without serving the kingdom of God. They look to their multimillionaire pastors and their possessions and want to be just like them. Whereas the greatest in the kingdom is a humble servant. B. The gospel of Protestantism, faith alone salvation, once saved, always saved, easy believism. People have chosen to follow the gospel of the reformers. Many Protestant denominations find excuse for divorce and remarriage, that is scriptural adultery. C. The Catholic gospel. There are many pagan doctrines taught by the Roman Church. Mary is not the Queen of Heaven, is not to receive prayers, for idolaters will not enter heaven. D. Almost all denominations preach strange eschatology. For example, you can find amillennialism taught in most major denominations. Be not deceived. You must follow the Jesus of the Bible. False gospels will not save you. Jesus said his way is the only way. You're either with him or you're against him. There is no other way. Many just listen to the pastor's opinion without obeying the words of Jesus. The keys of the kingdom are in your hands. They're written down for you. Make every effort to study it and follow it. Pray and ask the Spirit to teach you. Follow him.